Welcome back to HWLRadio.com. You're here with your main man, Hollywood. And if y'all thought Love and Hip Hop Atlanta wasn't going to pick up steam anymore, then think again, because today, well, not today, but yesterday, Tommy Lee is thankful as she is out of jail for the 4th of July. And here goes the story. The Love and Hip Hop Atlanta star, who was put in jail for beating her daughter at her school, takes to Instagram to share a short clip of her inside a car seemingly on her way back home. A showbiz. Tommy Lee celebrated the 4th of July with freedom. The Love and Hip Hop Atlanta star finally got out of jail on Thursday with her family, throwing a welcome home party for the reality TV star. Tommy, who was put in jail for beating her daughter at her school, took to her Instagram account to share a short clip of her inside a car seemingly on her way back home. She looked all glam in a plunging white and red outfit and a matching veil. So thankful, she wrote in the video. Another video saw her family and friends welcoming her home at a party. The words Big Sis Home Celebrations flickered on the screen. Tommy, whose real name is Natasha Jefferson, later came to the screen before flashing a smile at the camera. I pray she comes home and focus on rebuilding herself and her relationship with her children, an Instagram user wrote in the comment section under the Shade Room post. Now don't get locked up again, another one added. While previous comments saw people wishing her the best and being optimistic about her changing for the better, some others were the exact opposite, assuming that she wouldn't have her freedom for long. One critic said, "We'll see how long she can stay out this time. At this point, I'm convinced she likes being locked up." One other wrote, "She going back in 3, 2, 1. The VH1 previously pleaded guilty to one count of cruelty to children in the first degree, 3 counts of simple battery, family violence, and 1 count of disrupting public school. The terms of the probation restrict her from having any violent contact with the child, traveling outside the state of Georgia without written approval, and attending work and promotional events where drugs or alcohol are present. The star was also given an 11 p.m. curfew and must pay a $1,000 fine in addition to submitting to random drug and alcohol testing. According to the publication, the VH1 star has been attending the program. Tommy was arrested last fall after she shoved her daughter's head in a locker. When she went to the girls' middle school and disrupted the class, the indictment document further stated that she slapped her daughter on the hands with her purse strap and also slapped her across the face. She was charged with felony aggravated assault, battery, and child cruelty. She initially faced 54 years in prison. Last month, the reality TV star was arrested for appearing drunk in court for a hearing of the child abuse case. Issuing an apology for her behavior, she said in a statement, "I've been working really hard through my problems considering the challenges that's been set before me. Since I've been home, I've done all that I can do on my own to shake my habits, but I do realize that I need help and I am currently seeking treatment." Well, I can tell you one thing, Tommy, you can get with me, cause we gonna have lots of fun, and I'm gonna get you definitely off of that shit. Cause I can see from Love and Hip Hop, she needs a real fucking man. She needs somebody that's gonna basically like help her and guide her. That's what a lot of women need, is help and guidance. But if you don't want to accept guidance from your help, then shit, all I can tell you is good luck with the rest of these niggas. Because, boy, I know these niggas. Now, just say that. Boy. But that's why they say when you get somebody good, you better hold on to them. But I'm happy that Tommy Lee is out of motherfucking jail. And some of these kids do need their asses whooped. That's true. But at the same time, even the Bible tells you, you gotta abide by these people's laws because they are in charge of the land. The curse is still on you. So if you won't sit here and act like you are the higher favor, the world will show you. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and get on out of here. But that was the show for today. So go over to HWLRadio.com, download the radio station app. Make sure you check out the sponsors page. If you don't want to do that, go over to the Alexa skill app, search HWLRadio.com, enable it, and then you could tell Alexa to play the radio station app. And if you don't want to listen to no music and you just want to hear the show, or you want to catch up to the show all day long, and your boss don't allow you to look at YouTube at work, then you can download the podcast on Google Play and on iTunes at Hollywood KC 27 Live Podcast. And I'm out.
Damn.